Earlier this morning, on December 23, 2024, at 2:19 a.m. local time, a body of magma burst through the caldera floor of Kilauea, starting a new volcanic eruption. What started as a northeast-trending fissure eruption on the very southwestern edge of Kilauea's summit caldera slowly progressed further and further to the northeast, with the eruptive fissure likely reaching a maximum length of 3,500 feet or 1,067 meters. Multiple closely spaced vents were soon erupting along a line of activity, creating lava fountains propelled upwards by expanding gas to heights of 80 meters or 262 feet. Lava subsequently covered 220 acres of ground in the first 18 minutes and by 2 hours later had spread to cover 442 acres of ground. All of this is safely occurring purely within the latest iteration of Kilauea's summit caldera, which specifically formed in 2018, with no threat at the present of lava suddenly erupting at new locations in either of its two rift zones. In other words, no structures are at risk. Although, due to how quickly the lava lake has risen, one of the scientific cameras the U.S. Geological Survey placed is potentially at risk of being inundated by fresh lava and thus destroyed, specifically its B2 cam. Since this is a purely effusive VEI0 eruption, which is not currently threatening people or structures, the eruption can be safely viewed. Yes, people are currently allowed to visit at specific designated viewing locations along Kilauea's caldera rim. I have linked a relevant website on screen and in this video's description for more information. The reason why lava is effusively erupting here rather than explosively at, say, Sakurajima, largely relates to the viscosity of the lava which erupts. The reason for this is that the higher of a viscosity a volcano's lava has, the more gas and volatiles it can trap underneath it instead of being vented somewhat passively. Thus, at high viscosity volcanoes, this gas and pressure successfully gets trapped underneath a plug that forms built-in pressure until it cracks overlying rock and then fragments material to form an explosive eruption. Meanwhile, at Kilauea, gas and volatiles for the most part are easily released. Kilauea's lavas are basaltic with a viscosity 136 times lower than that of Sakurajima's and acidic lavas, and this is almost entirely due to a small composition difference of 10% more by weight silica at Sakurajima. While eruptive activity has notably declined, it is still ongoing multiple hours later, albeit largely restricted to the first portion of the fissure which initially erupted. Kilauea's briefer summit eruptions tend to start out with the highest rate of lava effusion and then subsequently slowly decline over time until the eruptive rate drops below 2 cubic meters per second and the eruption ends. Lava at the present is still flowing towards the east within the caldera, but do not let that distract you from the fact that something special has now occurred due to this latest eruption. That being, for the first time in 50 years, a distinct eruption has occurred in Kilauea's southwest rift zone, east rift zone, and summit all in the same year. However, with a gas plume from the eruption now drifting towards the southwest, it is likely to create a level of vog or volcanic fog. Vog plumes contain both sulfur dioxide and sulfuric acid as a component and greatly reduce visibility. However, at least as of the writing of this video, there were no signs of potentially harmful levels of these gases being detected at nearby towns. Although we do not know how long the current eruption will last, it probably will last for at least a week, with the duration of the last three summit eruptions at Kilauea being 8 days, 13 days, and 62 days respectively. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Denise L. Draper, for supporting this channel.